not due to neglect and ignorance. This is something which has been hidden and manipulated out of us Sabahan. In this briefing, I'm going to cover a few facts with support of authentic documents through careful reading and thorough understanding of the real history, the reasoning behind them, and steps to complete the process. I urge your honorable attendees tonight to have an open mind and full understanding of the implication of wrong decision to the future of Sabah as a nation. Ladies and gentlemen, towards the end of the briefing, you will see that Sabah has not gained its independence yet, and there is still a process to complete our decolonization. Allow me to begin. In 1881, Sabah, North Borneo then, was the protectorate of the British up until the World War II. After the World War II, Sabah became the colony of British. I believe, ladies and gentlemen, many of you who have visited Buckingham Palace would have noticed the pillar where all the colonies of the British listed down would include North Borneo. There is no doubt, ladies and gentlemen, that Sabah was one of the colonies of British. In 1960, the United Nations started a movement of granting independence to colonial countries. United Nations Resolution 1514, Chapter 15, titled Declaration on the Granting of Independence to Colonial Countries and Peoples, also known as Declaration of Decolonization. It was on the conscience of the need for creation of conditions of stability and well-being and peaceful and friendly relations based on respect for the principles of equal rights and self-determination. They believed that the colonization prevents the development of the international economy, cooperation, impedes the social, cultural, and economic development of dependent peoples, and militates against the United Nations ideal of universal peace. Ladies and gentlemen, United Nations plays the important role in assisting the movement for independence in trust and non-self-governing territories. It was on this principle that the British began its decolonization on Sabah. We must be very clear that under the British colonization, Sabah is a non-governing entity. On 9 July 1963, Malaysia Agreement was signed between North Borneo, Sarawak, Singapore, Federation of Malaya, and United Kingdom. Ladies and gentlemen, please remember that Sabah was the colony of British. Hence, when they signed this agreement, two things have to be kept in mind. Number one, Sabah was still a minor. Hence, the United Kingdom signed the agreement as the guardian for Sabah. Two, the commencement date of the agreement is on the day of creation of Federation of Malaysia. By that time, Sabah will have the capacity as a self-governing territory. Therefore, there is no question on whether Sabah was having capacity to sign on its own behalf. On 31st July 1963, Malaysia Act 1963, Chapter 35 was passed. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to bring your attention to Section 1.1, which states that for the purpose of enabling North Borneo, Sarawak and Singapore, in this act referred to as the new states, to federate with the existing states of the Federation of Malaya, in this act referred to as the Federation. The Federation thereafter being called Malaysia, on the day on which new states are federated as aforesaid, in this act referred to as the appointed day. Her Majesty's sovereignty and jurisdiction in respect of the new states shall be relinquished so as to vest in the manner agreed between the United Kingdom of the Great Britain and Northern Ireland, the Federation and the new states. This section, ladies and gentlemen, describes the relationship between Sabah and Malaya. The word to vest means a trust. The word in manner agreed refers to Malaysia Agreement 1963. The trustee here will be Malaysia due to the last sentence in the section after the comma, the Federation and the new states. In other words, it means British relinquished its right on Sabah upon trust to Malaysia, based on what is agreed upon in the Malaysia Agreement 1963. On 14 September 1963, the United Nations passed another resolution, 1541, for the purpose of being clearer on the principle enunciated in the resolution 1514. Under principle 6, UN resolution 1541, it states that a non-self-governing territory can be said to have reached a full measure of self-government by A, emergence as sovereign independent state, B, free association with an independent state, or C, integration with an independent state. Ladies and gentlemen, when Sabah, Sarawak and Singapore was integrated with the Federation of Malaya, it was under principle 6C, integration with an independent state, because the Federation of Malaya was already an independent state. This integration was for the purpose of decolonization. Bear in mind, ladies and gentlemen, Malaysia Agreement 1963 was registered in the United Nations under Treaty Collection Number 10760, because creation of Malaysia was for the purpose of assisting non-self-governing territory like Sabah for decolonization process. Once Sabah integrated with Malaya, Sabah becomes a full measure self-government. Therefore, on 31st August 1963, before integration, Sabah was only a de facto self-government territory. We have not attained independence yet. We are still in the process of decolonization. On 16 September 1963, we created Malaysia. Only at this stage, ladies and gentlemen, Sabah reached full measure self-government territory. If this is a process, it has to have a beginning and an ending. Under the United Nations Resolution 1541, Article 73E requires the Trust Administrator to transmit regularly to the Secretary General for information purpose the statistical and other information of a technical nature relating to economic, social, and educational condition in the territories for which they are respectively responsible. Meaning, Malaysia must transmit report to the Secretary General of the United Nations relating to Sabah of their progress in economic, social, and educational condition. With this report, the decolonization process will be completed. From full measure self-government territory, Sabah will then become an independent state. The report under Article 73E, United Nations Resolution 1541, will conclude the process of decolonization. Ladies and gentlemen, until to date, there was no such report ever transmitted to the United Nations, despite it has been long overdue. Fortunate for us that the Council of Trusteeship of the United Nations have their meeting every year, and this year it will be held in November 2021. It is still not too late to send the report, still not too late to complete the process. However, it will halt forever if we allow ourselves to believe that we have gained our independence on 31st August 1963 and declare Sabah Day. I thank you.